Cal, thank you for correcting.
If we're all ready, we can begin.
I think we're ready.
Yeah, I'm more or less ready.
Hi, yep. Everybody. Welcome I'm back ready. To another episode of Cal Benchin Plays.
What?
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 All right, so... Why is my pain so high? There we go, went back down.
Words, Marcus.
Words, things, stuffs, rolls, items. Oh,
pancakes.
Okay.
Yeah, my pain keeps going so high.
Yeah, I'm experiencing your high ping.
I don't have anything going on right now.
So, before we continue, I do have to say, one of my coworkers said that he was my sensei today.
Maybe it's the tablet? I'll delete that and see
Could
if...
be.
He was my sensei, know. So I told him, you know, you're right. And he goes, what, you're not going to fight me? And I was like, no, you're quite sensational.
Out of your sensei.
Why did we invite him again?
I don't know. I don't know. So,
why couldn't he have just been that sick?
Last time, you guys all came into a city. You met each other. Kelb helped out a guy with his shop real quickly. And you created your team that can potentially become part of the guild as a sub-guild or as a guild. Because this is a weird version of a guild hall. Nevertheless...
Team like Rainbow Unicorn Destruction?
No. Your team is the Outlanders? Yes.
Indeed.
The Outlanders.
I typed in the Outsiders. Fuck, I need to go correct that in my Twitch title.
Damn it, Tate.
Way to go, Tate.
God damn it, both of the cats are in here now.
You got to calling yourself the Outlanders. Kelb's character does know where to go to sign up for the tournament because he went there and was told that he should have a team to sign up for the tournament. And that's where we left off, is when you were going to go to that spot to sign yourselves up.
Good news.
You guys
have my
banner, right?
No, he got here because Des Moines dragged him over to the counter.
Indeed.
Yep.
So, we'll begin. Everyone ready?
I'm ready. I'm ready.
Over me.
Okay.
Oh, by the way, Marcus, remind me to send you my character sheet after this.
Yep. So, you look at the little map and that spot that says Guildhall, heading towards the Colosseum. Does anyone have the ability to use Detect Magic and wishing to use said ability to detect magic?
God damn it, and of course I have my spells at home.
I know that, as a matter of fact.
No.
I do have Detect Magic.
I have a Fly Armor, by the way.
But I don't see why my character would be using it.
It's just out of curiosity if your character desires to detect magic or not.
I have detect alignment, magic. But I don't think I have detect magic.
No, that's fine. So, you approach the Colosseum. This is a massive looking building, circular, as you can see on the crude picture that I sort of drew very good. You can either roll a spot and or gather information, but it'd be more of a spot should you be looking around as you approach where Kelb's character is leading you. Does anyone actively look around at their surroundings, or are you all deadpanned in one direction?
I'm checking things out.
Okay.
Yeah, so am I. I'm just happen to be the one to look around when I'm
traveling with Tate.
I'm still wary of these fools.
Somebody's looking out for us, Lamb.
I'll be looking around as well.
Alright, so go ahead and roll spot.
I still have 15 minutes on the download.
Yep.
Wow, Noah.
So, for Lamb...
Uh-oh, background changed.
Did Noah roll a 1 or a 20?
Add a 15 to your spot, Lamb. That's what you rolled.
Spot. 16.
16? Okay.
Get a plus one.
Who else rolled?
I did.
What'd you get, Des Mois?
I got a 5, but I'll add 8 to that. I mean, 10. So 15 total. 15 total.
15, 16. Anyone else Six. Rolling to spot? 6?
I rolled an 8.
8?
I just High rolled rollers. A fucking 20.
Okay, Tate got a 20.
We're just walking to the Colosseum. Why am I using this
25.
Project? Just to take notice.
I know where it is. I'm going there.
Yeah. I mean, they're checking out as they're walking. And you guys should realize that the city guards that have been around are wearing armor and wielding weapons that are matching the Colosseum's aesthetic design very, very closely, as if perhaps the person in charge of the Colosseum could potentially be in charge of the city. That might not seem
too
important,
power.
But it sort of is.
Well, considering the Colosseum is probably a way they make a lot of tourist money. It's how they run quite a bit of their economy boosts.
Yep. So, once you reach the entrance area of the said Colosseum, which has the booths, there's the same booth you saw earlier, Kelb, with the gentleman. Looks like he's open for you to come up to. Does people approach him?
Naturally, I think we're all going to meander towards him.
Personally,
at least I'm going to.
I lead the group to go towards them. Since I'm the one that knew where the Colosseum was, I'm imagining I would be leading the group anyway.
So, you approach the booth with the gentleman there, and he spots you, Kelb, and he goes, "Ah, looks like you found yourself a team."
Why, yes, I did. So how do we sign up?
Well, he pulls out a couple pieces of paper. First, I need your team name, your names, and what you would consider your expertise in. You know, if you're some sort of archer or brawler or bear wrestler. You know, whatever you think you're the best to be described as.
Does lumberjack count?
Does your character actually say that?
Maybe.
No, Tate.
Is that a yes or is it a no?
Yes, it is.
Well, I suppose it could.
Lamb, you weren't very good at lumberjacking.
So, I assume you write down the Outlanders. Then you write down Hellfire. What would you call yourself, Kelb? Fighter?
Yeah. Also,
and
it's
then,
really fucking hard to find an HDRI Colosseum image.
I imagine it probably is. Lamb, would you use your full name or just part of it?
I would probably just use Orfel, which is my surname.
Wait, you have... I don't even have that written down.
I think it should be on my character sheet. Since it's on the one I got from you.
Yeah, it is. I must have written the wrong last name.
What you have is my last name.
Sarel.
What?
I mean, there's an L and an R.
What?
Anyway, so Orfel Would you call yourself just like the sorcerer, or...
I would probably put down magical anomaly. Because I have no idea what the fuck I would be considered.
Alright. Tate?
I would probably just put down Avena.
He just signs it with his whole hand.
Okay.
And what would you put down? As per usual. And I write down for my profession.
Lumberjack?
Hunter extraordinaire.
Okay.
No, not lumberjack. I was considering making that my profession, but nah.
Alright, Jared? Zephyr?
Zephyr? Scout.
Scout? Noah?
You're muted.
You're muted.
No, did you clear the name?
Totson?
Tucson?
Tucson?
Arizona?
You call yourself Tucson? Would you also just put fighter, or would you put something other than fighter?
Duelist.
Duelist?
It's the best I can do.
Is it time to duel?
Shut the fuck up.
And
just not that I'm not a fighter, or else I would be like making some kind of slam joke.
Okay, right. Mr. No Means.
I would put that in semi-L. Can I roll knowledge of culture before I put down my profession?
Sure. Go ahead.
Can I just say this background did not turn out the way it was supposed to?
The easy way, Des Moines, is just click R on it. Just click R and hold on R.
I did.
And then it will roll it.
Yeah, I got 14, so plus 8.
I'll split out my character's information.
22. I got 22.
Although magic doesn't seem excessively prominent in this area, you know that this area does not have any issue with magic, so you would be totally fine stating something with magic. Now, if you were to say you were the Breener of Armageddon, you might have a few eyes watching you, but...
Can I change it's one of those things like, written down?
No. A few people, like... No one's going to necessarily care too much, but again, if you're like, I'm the Antichrist, well, I mean, you know, you're going to have those few look at you. So,
no, he wouldn't, because people don't know who Christ is in this dimension.
Well, I was using a real world, god damn it.
I know, I'm sorry.
No, I wanted to make sure that I didn't want to put down magic if magic was not acceptable in here, even though it is mentioned. I wanted to make sure that it wouldn't be looked down upon.
That's fine. So, what would you have your profession be stated as?
I guess warlock. Class of warlock. I don't know. That's what my class is.
So, the warlock?
Yeah, I guess warlock would be my profession.
Okay.
Maybe magic user, and then in, like, quotes, spooky.
It's not spooky, it's divine.
Spooky magic.
The spooky divine.
I'll just put down magic user then. I'll put down magic user as my profession.
Okay. So that's what you guys tell him. Or write down. And he goes, fantastic. Now, he flips it to the next sheet. What I need you to do is decide who shall partake in what. Upon quick glance, you all see that it says day 1, arrow range, bardic battle, sparring. Day 2, dodging, magical ability show off. Day 3, drinking, bardic boss battle concert, animal handling. And day 4, the gauntlet, with little parentheses saying team. All the others are solo, except for magical ability and bardic battle, which are solo, but you're able to have more than one person partake in it. So first, your choice is who will do arrow range? Who's going to do the shooting?
Hands go up. I think I would probably be best at that.
So do you jump right on it? You go, me, and just sign it before they can even say anything?
It's more of my hand would go up and be like, I think I would take that. The arrows, we'll do the shooting.
I assume Kelba's the one writing down the names. Do you write down Avena as doing that?
I was under the impression that we were swapping turns writing each other's name.
It doesn't really matter. It's up to you guys. Did you guys have Kelb's character write everything? Or did Hellfire pass it and then it just kept getting passed?
I think we need to discuss this openly between our team.
About who's writing or about who's participating in what?
On who's participating in what? Maybe both. Okay.
You guys pass it around and it found its way back to the forefront, which was Kelb's character in the very beginning. Kelb currently has it.
Kelb right
here. Avena went, I can do it.
I can do the arrow thingy.
Before writing her name, I ask if anyone else feels up to the task.
Jared, are you here or are you just muted?
No, I'm here. I was trying to think if my character would actually want to do it or not.
I just haven't heard your voice in a while, and I was...
Well, keep in mind, there's a whole bunch. There's also sparring, dodging, drinking, animal handling. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's 5 things. There's 6 of you, so one of you won't necessarily do one of these solo things. But that could always be someone that partakes in taking an instrument and trying to do the bardic part. Doing the magical ability show off to just show off their team's magical ability. Ultimately, you will be partaking in the gauntlet, so it's not like your character won't do anything at all. And these typically shouldn't take too long of a time for each person to do their thing.
I'm personally not proficient in both, so I will not take part in that.
Written on a second, on another piece of paper there with you, you guys will notice that there is a thing that says tournament rules. So while you're discussing this, one of you will notice this and point it out. What it says is, the games are done using only the following granted items, except for the gauntlet. The standard longbow is what you get in the archery competition. A sparring sword for the first round and all rounds after in the sparring competition, except for the final match, which can be agreed on as a final death match using long swords, rapiers, or scimitars. But all the other rounds are just a sparring sword. No weapons, armor, magical abilities, gear, nothing is allowed to be used like that in the dodging competition. A dagger, a quarterstaff, and padded armor are all you get in the animal handling or the animal handling competition. And then again, no weapons, armor, magic, or gear are going to be allowed in the drinking competition. So all of those use the things they let you use and give you, not your own stuff. So if you're like, I can do archery, but you can't use a longbow, well, they're not going to let you use your crossbow. Sorry.
Well, I am perfectly fine with using a longbow as I use a longbow.
The gauntlet, you get to use everything at your disposal. All your items, all your magic, all your weapons and armor. But not for the others.
So, tabletop's finished.
Would you like to have it where Tate's character then does the...
Yes, range? I write her name down.
Now I just have to go through the first time fucking...
Sparring! Who here wants to partake in the sparring?
I'm game.
Kelb, you'd be the other...
You did write down your name as duelist, so...
You'd be the other fighter. Are you okay with allowing Noah to do it?
Out of context, you said the drinking game was day one, or that was day two?
That is day three.
Oh, hold on. Okay.
Day one is just the arrow and the sparring. You have to fight and then drink.
I choose down to write whatever the fuck Noah's character's name is, because I don't remember it.
Okay.
You have to do sparring competition and drinking competition at the same time.
Drink fighting?
Yes.
Dodging. Who's going to be the one to show their ability to dodge?
I shall.
Anyone else now, wishing to have stuff shot at them and think they're going to be better?
Now, with this equipment restriction, are ropes fine?
You'll find out.
Dodging is based on AC, right?
Oh god, the game is so loud.
So
it's gonna be more of a reflex saving throw, depending on what the fuck's getting thrown at you or what's happening.
I'm not gonna lie, part of all this stuff is me just testing out different parts of your characters to see what I can kind of throw at you to an extent. But it's also a fun roleplay experience. Animal handling. Who wants to partake in that?
Ooh, me.
I don't suppose my cat would count.
Nope, this is literally
Wait,
you
answer,
trying to
is it one at a time?
Handle an animal. If Kelb, Lamb, and Jared don't want to do it, then you, Noah, or Des Moines would be totally allowed. But
I think
for the sake of allowing someone else to be able to also partake in the competition, I'd say let someone else potentially do it instead of just you right away.
True. I'd say Lamb. He knows how to handle an animal.
Do you vote him for him in game?
Yes.
Yes, I do.
I'm just gonna slowly back off, waving my hands toward. God, no. Are you kidding me? Do you want to see what happened last time I handled an animal? I point at Tate. That's what happened.
What do you do there?
I'm your
Kelb?
Greatest accomplishment.
Do you laugh and you just write, Orfell?
I do.
Okay. God damn it! I hate all of you.
Yes.
And then drinking. Who's gonna do drinking?
We have a dwarf, right, don't we? Just look at him. He's made for this.
Well,
for God's sake,
right,
he's
now,
a dwarf.
So you're gonna do that then, there, Kelb?
Yep.
I mean, it's free drinks.
Name. Right? Well, and I can still wear my armor.
Hopefully. Now,
we would know this, but Noah would be the best at it.
Well, it's based off of cotton.
I think actually Jared would probably be best at this, because we don't know that.
Lamb or Des Moines, would either of you like to show off your magical abilities?
My guy's mostly terrified of his magical abilities, so probably not.
Okay.
My character would.
All right.
I'm a bit of a show-off.
So is the one who dashed towards the fucking guild hall.
Exactly.
And does any of your characters have any ability with any magical, or not magical, musical instruments at all to try and partake in the bard battle?
Nope.
I considered it, even though I don't, but no.
Would that be a perform thing?
Yeah. Yes, it would, and you'd have to actually be trained in using an instrument.
I am not.
Neither am I.
Unless you count war axe as an instrument.
Is mayonnaise an No.
Line up the scopes.
Yeah, that's what I was referencing, Marcus.
Well,
yeah,
I got it. I have a string instrument, but it's mainly meant for hunting.
You're gonna sit there and just bum 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 bum. I'm sorry, guys. Bum. It's only one note. Bum bum bum.
No, you could actually alter the note if you play a bow. It just depends on how far from the center you go.
Question, Marcus. Yes. Would my language be considered that because I technically may seem as singing
sing.
To others?
No. not technically. Role playing wise, to an extent, yes. Mechanically, not quite. So I'm just going to go with a no on that one.
Okay, then no.
I do have one question. As you guys see where you're all sitting, you do currently have Demoist doing the magical show off and the dodging. Would you like to have Jared's character, being the rogue, actually do the dodging instead of the warlock? It's entirely up to you guys.
But that would really be better at it.
I would think so. Appreciate it. That's why I was questioning if my robes were allowed in the dodging.
You'll find out if they are or aren't. So
your robes
is that...
give you a dodge bonus or something?
Nope, but I'd rather not take them off.
Yeah, they might just be considered illegal.
But you don't know. So.
You could ask, right? Jared, ask the person.
I walk up and point out the paper. So, with these equipment restrictions for the dodging, it's not armor, but would these simple robes be suffice for entering the competition? As well as my mask.
I suppose so. They have no magical abilities, correct?
Correct.
I don't see why not.
Then I have no problem attempting this dodge feat you seem to have listed.
Dodge feat.
Okay. So he takes the paperwork and tells you that tomorrow is when the competition shall begin. What you guys had written is that on day one, you will have Tate do the arrow, and then you will have Noah do the sparring. Day two, you will have Jared do the dodging, Demoist do the magical show off. Day three, you'll have Kelb do the drinking, and Lamb do the animal handling. And then all six of you will partake in the gauntlet together. It does not give you any hint as to what the gauntlet is. All it is it says it's a team challenge. So, this is the night before. You guys know that you get to sleep in the guild hall for free since you are competing. So you don't have to find anywhere necessarily to sleep.
I take it the beds aren't so comfy, since my take is they do this a lot. They can't really afford comfy beds for temporary customers.
So, before you guys decide to go get your night's rest at the guild hall, does anyone intend to do anything in the city? Otherwise, I would say head right on back to the guild hall. You have enough time to do some small activities, but you don't have enough time to go, like...
repair a building.
Right, do a lot of jobs. This is probably close to close-up time for a lot of shops.
Fix the entire city.
Ask if there's a nearby library bookshop.
You did see...
God damn it.
God damn it, I know what you're doing now.
Yes.
I'm doing this for Tay, damn it.
All right, you ask the gentleman that you signed up. He looks a little confused, and he goes, well, sure, there's plenty. My personal favorite, he shows you on a map of the city, a little piece of parchment that has a crudely drawn map. Right?
Did he draw the map himself?
Yeah, it looks like my drawing.
It's great.
And
so
right,
this character is you.
It's right here. About right there. And that's my personal favorite.
Ask him what the name of the bookstore is.
It's called AJ's Fantastic, except the F, A, and N are all capital. Fantastic Bookstore.
I love it.
Okay, I'll head towards it to get a book.
Does anyone else go with him?
Nah, I'm good. My character doesn't really like books.
No, but I might head towards the Elven District.
Okay.
I'm probably gonna follow Lam. I'd feel more at home there with them, after all.
So, with how big the city is, you guys would have enough time to go there and kind of see what it looks like, but not enough time to actively explore or do much there, necessarily. Just to kind of see what it looks like in a big city.
Yeah.
Unless you intend to not get any sleep the night before, which for Tate's character will result in negatives and not be the best for him.
Oh no, I got sleep.
I don't have anything to worry about for till day three.
Yeah, you'll be fine, Lamb. This Tate will be fucked.
Well, AJ, think of it this way. Since the character that handed Des Moines the map handed a map of what Marcus drew, that character is now Marcus. So, AKA, if it's his favorite store... Your fanfictions are coming to life, AJ.
No, that character's a bit older than me. You want to know what character I am in this story, Tate? My character is known as God, because I'm the DM. That's my character. I'm every character.
But I thought there was a whole pantheon of gods.
Marcus, your name should have been Dominic Martinez. You know, DM.
Yes. All right.
I'll check out a bar somewhere near the Colosseum or the Guild Hall and just listen in on the drunks.
There was a bar within the Guild Hall.
I don't know why, but I imagine Jared just sitting there like
all right. So
like Aragorn.
I will get to you two in a minute to get to the two that aren't going to be able to do too excessively much, Tate and Lam. Oh, well, I guess let's see. Where are you gonna go, Noah?
I'm gonna be heading straight to bed.
Okay, so you go to the Guild Hall too, so you're with those two. Alright, so Lam and Tate, you guys head up here. Up to the elven
area. The awkward peaks of the city.
Yeah, my hand-drawn drawing looks nicer, but oh well.
It's an alien leg. Just giving you a heads up.
And, it's not that it's necessarily run down, but they've definitely allowed nature to take it over partially. So where parts of the city has pristine like brick and cobblestone work, this might have grass growing in it or moss on it. So it's not necessarily run down, but they're allowing nature to coexist with it.
So I want to ask if it's similar to something. Have you played BioShock at all?
I haven't. I tried playing a little bit of the second one, and I just couldn't.
That's fine. I was just thinking of a specific zone, and if you haven't played it, then there's no point in me asking.
Right. This is not familiar to you, as far as elvens go, because what you're used to is very natural homing. Whereas this is more letting nature be part of it, but it's obviously not built with it. Like, a lot of your houses are one with a tree, and this might have a tree growing off of it or next to it, but it's not necessarily built with the tree.
Are all the people staring at me again?
Do you have your cloak on?
I never got a cloak.
I thought you had a cloak.
No, that's Jared.
Oh, it's Jared. Well, yeah, you're always being looked at.
Oh my.
Doing the best I can, by the way, with the backgrounds.
It's just a black hole underneath of us.
Yeah, don't look down on most of these images.
What happens if I look up? Oh my god, space. Those towers climb infinitely high.
So, that's what you guys see. Do you wish to head back to the Guild Hall then, or?
Yeah, after being slightly disappointed, my guy would just head back to the Guild Hall.
Alright. So yeah, you see there aren't any massive trees, and there aren't any, necessarily huts that are made almost out of living tree or out of mud. Not necessarily mud, but it's all clearly more human. Yeah, more domesticated, more what humans or humans or dragonborn would make rather than elves.
It's a unique.
Thankfully, it doesn't quite look dwarven. You know, it's not dwarvish. That's a relief.
Fucking dwarves.
Wow.
You know, for the people that don't know, within this world, just like any other world, dwarves and elves don't exactly like each other excessively. Can, just like Lord of the Rings, but innately they don't. Nevertheless, you guys head back. Before we get to when you two enter the guild hall, though, we will also swap over to Demois. Demois, you get outside AJ's fantastic store. What do you enter?
Yes, if it's open.
It is open.
AJ, your bookstore is fan-fucking-tastic.
So you enter the bookstore, and there are quite a few books in there, and there is,
There's a butt plug or two.
No.
Oh.
God. It's a subtle reference, not a full thing. There's a woman behind the counter.
What's the woman's name? Ask, do you have any books, stories?
Oh, I have a fantastic one. She goes over to a shelf, pulls out a, kind of white-spined book, and hands it to you. Do you look at the front?
Yes. I looked at it.
It is a book called The Neverending Room. If we're going to have the references, I might as well go all the way.
First part is, I'm thinking of like 20 different things that references.
Tate never left the room.
I never left the room. I'm still in there right now.
His
I'm
portal
in the room.
Or my portal map I made for him that was just the same room repeating but changing every now and then.
That's my favorite fucking cube
just
movies.
Like, yes.
Yeah.
I agree with this.
So, that's what she gives you.
Do you have any books on history as well?
Let's see. I have folklore, but not like history.
That'd be fine.
All right, she hands you a book on folklore, most of it being just random tales from different races. Some of them you already know, thanks to living near the human city, but not in the city. Some of it, you know, just due to your own research. Some of it's new.
I'll take both. How much are they?
Well, for both of those, that's going to be 2 gold.
Thank you. I hand her 2 gold and head back towards the guild house.
All right. Make sure on your character sheet you take 2 gold off of your monies.
I feel like he just got ripped off.
Depending on the size of the books now.
So.
It's not like he was asking for a Necronomicon.
Yeah.
I don't know if you're going to find a Necronomicon.
I'll make the Necronomicon.
Okay, I did.
Alright.
Took gold off.
So
there
do you head back?
There also has to be a book somewhere in there about young love.
There might be, but those are the 2 books he went for.
Two young friends.
So, do you head back to the guild hall? Demois.
Yes.
Alright. You head back, and on your way back, you enter the guild hall, and before I continue with you, Kelb Noah and Jared, you guys enter the guild hall about the same time. Noah, you said you go straight to your room?
I'm heading to sleep.
Okay. So you guys enter in, and this would be the point in which, Noah, you realize you don't have a room yet, so you probably should ask Clara for a room.
AJ would have all the folklore.
To head over to Clara.
Noah, why are you so quiet?
Noah's so far away.
I can't hear you at all,
because
Noah.
You don't want to hear the dogs in the background, because my parents just got home.
Oh. So you go up to Clara and you ask her for a room?
Yes, a room for the night where I can sleep.
Alright. Well, she goes, okay, so you will be in room such and such, hands you a key for it. And that's it?
Okay. I'll take the key and be on my way.
Okay. Well, for the sake of simplicity, although these will not be the room numbers, but for the sake of simplicity, we'll call it room 1.
Oh, we're not going to use the letters?
Room 1. N. What?
Room N?
It's room N. No, or just, for simplicity, the number or letter that the room is can be something, but for the sake of this, we're going to call it just 1. Maybe it's 396 N. I don't know. It's a weird number, but whatever. Especially since there's 396 rooms in this building, apparently, now.
biggest guild hall ever. Dimensional
so,
space.
You go to room 1, and you go to go sleep. Jared and Kelb, you guys go to the left, because when you enter in, directly in front of you is a receptionist, which is where Clara sits. To your right was a library. To your left was a bar, a eatery of such. So you went to the left, and you might have noticed Noah's character talk to Clara and then go up the stairs, but you guys enter into the bar. I'm assuming Kelb goes to the bartender.
I immediately walk up to the bartender and ask if they have dwarven ale.
And Jared, what are you doing while he does this?
I find a seat somewhere near where the loudest drunks are.
Okay. So. Yeah. The bartender absolutely has dwarven ale, Kelb.
I asked for a pint.
For a pint. Mm-hmm. All right.
That'll be 1 gold piece.
Marcus is typing, which bothers me.
Yeah, I'm trying to be quiet about it.
What? No, I'm saying it bothers me that you're typing down something.
Oh.
That was random.
I literally have no idea how much the alcohol and food necessarily costs. I was just kind of...
I want to say Dwarven Ale was half a gold, but I really don't recall.
That's what I made it cost for the other group, and I want to make sure I wasn't wrong. These are all homebrew ones that someone made up that were interesting, but... whatever.
The ODST.
Half a gold. Well, he goes, are you a member of the guild yet?
I am. Not.
I was going to say, you're going to have to roll a bluff on that. All right, well, I'm going to have to let you know that until you're a part of the guild, I have to charge you double. It's going to be a whole gold.
I'm okay with that.
All right, so you give him a gold piece, you get your pint. Do you go sit down with other people, or just stay there and drink it at the bar, or what do you do?
I look around the room to see if there are any other dwarves.
There is. Oddly enough, Jared is sitting near the other dwarves.
Oh, fucking course he is.
There is 4 of them. And they all have a matching set of armor. And they seem to be not getting rowdy, but being kind of rowdy. Like, they're loud and boisterous, but they're not breaking anything.
Do I notice if they are out of beer or ale or whatever the hell they may be drinking?
Looks like it's full. There's a couple other empty cups around them, but the current ones are... They're not full, but they've only had a couple drinks out of it. Two swigs, maybe. So, you know, it's only down by a fourth.
Yeah, it sounds about right for a dwarf.
Yeah.
Also, I hate you. You ruined my plan.
What were you going
to
do?
Oh, hold on. Were you going to get them drunk? Introduce
myself?
Oh. Yeah,
no. Dave.
You could give it a few seconds and let them drink it down. They're not going to take that long to get lowered.
Fair enough. I sit at the bar then and wait for them to get closer to finishing their drinks.
All right. While you're doing this then, before you get over to there, well, no, just as you are about to get.
Words again, Marcus?
Words. Yeah.
Marcus?
My brain is breaking, apparently. They get their drinks lowered, so now would be your chance to get them drinks.
How far along do you think I would be in my drink at this point?
Probably about half if you were drinking it only to drink it, but not to get to that point yet. Enough okay, to.
You said there were three other dwarves over there?
Yep.
I asked bartender for four more dwarven ales.
Okay. You chug down yours and then head on over?
Yeah, I finished the rest of the one I had and bring the four drinks over there, three for them and one for me.
All right, just have to mark down how many drinks you have.
I've been marking down my money already.
Oh, no. Not for that. For how much you've drank.
Oh.
I've absolutely already made a couple characters have to do stuff after they had... One of them had four shots and four drinks. The fort saves were not made. Two party members got puked on.
As I approach them, I introduce myself in Dwarven.
All right. They all look at you, kind of, you know, like, a kin. Des Moines.
Yes.
You enter into the guild hall just in time to see Kelb's character walking out of view because of the wall and hearing, does your character understand Dwarven?
May check. I'll have to look.
It should be second page on the bottom. Yep, okay. Hearing him say, you know, his name and howdy to him, or hello, or whatever he says.
Howdy.
I don't. I said howdy, and I was like, well, dwarves aren't cowboys, so. Howdy, I'm a dwarf!
Stone ranchers.
Wait, Stone Rancher?
Yeah, Slime Rancher.
What are common Scottish greetings?
Howdy!
I don't know.
Anyway, so that's what you hear. Do you intend to go meet your friend? Or do you intend just to go straight to bed? Or read your books in your room?
I'd most likely read my books in my room. So I'm going to go to my room and read my books.
Well, first you need to go up to Clara and get a room. Again, okay. You don't have one yet.
Oh, okay. I'll go up to... Hey, Clara. Did she say her name? Well, just assume she did.
I think she said her name.
What's my room number?
Well, I guess I'll give you the other key to your... to a room that your other party member just went to. She hands you a key. It's for room 1. He already went up there, so, you know, she's probably already ready to, for you.
thank you. And I, after she hands me the key, I head to my room.
All right. Jared, what you notice is, do you know Dwarven, Jared?
I do not.
Okay, so you have no idea what Kelb just said, but he walked over to him, said something, the other dwarves were like, ha-ha! And all took the drinks from him, and what do you intend to do now, Kelb?
I ask him, still in Dwarven, of course, why they're here.
They tell you that, and Dwarven, that they are part of a guild known as the Stone Dwarves, and, or no, they're the...
original.
They're the...
Right.
Fine. They're the elf lovers.
Why didn't you just go with Order of the Stone? Make a fucking reference.
Oh, God.
Sure. They're Order of the Stone.
Yes.
And they're just here after completing a mission, celebrating, finishing a mission that they just did. And they'll be off on another one here soon enough. They didn't say what mission, they just said a mission they were on.
I ask about some of their past tales that they may be willing to share.
They tell you about how they saved a village from some undead, and how they were once attacked in the middle of the night by a large pack of wolves. They tell you about the latest mission they just did, which was more or less retrieving stuff or a village. They don't seem to give too much detail on the last mission, but...
Good job, Marcus.
What?
Not wanting to add the detail.
No, they're... You can sense motive. They are definitely keeping information.
Or are they?
Oh, no, they are. You could assume maybe they haven't gotten paid for it yet and they don't want you to claim it.
Fair enough.
But it's the other group. Don't listen to him.
They're definitely not telling you what they did. Just...
I ask them if they're taking part into the competition.
They go, no, we've been a guild for a little while now, so we're not new anymore. We're not allowed to partake in this one. One of the more advanced ones? Yeah, we might partake in it again. Maybe we can compete against your guild.
Perhaps, but not presently in a guild. Kind of found a random bunch of travelers, and we're actually competing in the starting guild tournament.
And they just kind of, like, boisterously laugh to themselves, in a sense, and go, well, best of luck to you, lad. Well, we gotta be off. They all chug down their drinks and head on over to where Clara's at. See him talk. Do you stop him or anything?
Before they actually get up to leave,
okay.
I do say that I hope to see them in the advanced tournaments in the future.
One of the ones, which hasn't talked yet, goes... No, I was going to make him have a high-pitched voice, but I don't think I want to anymore.
Please don't.
He seems younger than the others, even though he still has a very full beard like them.
And he just tells
you, you can bet on it. And then they head up to Clara. You see her give them some money, or a pouch of what you would assume to be money. Parchment, and then they head on out the door.
I take a look around the room.
Alright. As you look around, Tate and Lamb, this is when you two enter. You guys wait right outside as some dwarves exit a building. The building. And, You're able to enter in right after them. The young one, the youngest-ish one, you might not think is young. Maybe your guys are racist and they think all dwarves look the same. I don't know. Is definitely looking at Tate. And then just keep going with the others. Now you can tell he's looking at her out of the corner of his eye, kind of like a, what?
Well, we're used to this sort of thing by now. And after my disappointing discovery that the Elven District wasn't similar to the place I grew up, I think I would... Well, I think my character is just going to go walk up to... What is your name? Clara?
Yep.
You said?
Yep.
Walk up to Clara and say, Oh, God, I had it in my head for so long, and now it's gone. Fantastic. And going to ask if he would be able to get into a room.
Are you going to clarify which room you're in?
Wow. 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 Well,
I stabbed Tate in real life.
Can we anyway. All stab him?
God damn
just
it.
Take a turn stabbing right? in real life?
Right? Anyway.
Anyway.
God damn it, Tate.
As you're looking around, Kel, you notice your friends walk in. I'd say
Where
you probably
Jared,
would notice
by
this.
The way?
You would probably notice this too, Jared. And you see them walk up to Clara. Do either of you do anything?
I'm asking if I noticed Jared.
Oh yeah, you knew he was right there near the dwarves, just listening in. But did you continue to listen in, Jared, even though you couldn't understand what they were saying?
I took notice every once in a while to see if I could understand, but mostly I was just listening around the room to see if anyone was talking about the tournament.
I got to shut up.
Gotcha. Not really. Most of them were just talking about jobs they were doing or did. And for the most part, it was all very basic stuff. Nothing that's like a superhero-esque whatever type of stuff. I don't know how to necessarily word it. It's nothing crazy. It's like, oh, we escorted this. Or, oh, we rescued such and such. But it's not like, oh, we stopped a war. Or we killed a dragon. Nothing sane like that. It's all very, you could say, low tier.
We built a catapult for terrorists.
We built... No, that... I gotta pause real quick. That was with my other group that we were joking around about.
Oh,
there's
God.
The alternate universe. Since, you know, there's a universe for everything. But there's a universe where everything is a Tarrasque. Grass is actually just a whole bunch of little Tarrasques on the world, which is a Tarrasque, with Tarrasques walking around asking each other if they read Tarrasque.
Level up Tarrasque.
The Tarrasque. Part 2.
Level 1 Tarrasque, Tarrasque.
All the Tarrasque.
To Tarrasque or not to Tarrasque. From
Buffalo, Buffalo, Tarrasque, Buffalo, Buffalo, Tarrasque. Buffalo, Buffalo, Buffalo.
Anyway.
Jurassic Park?
Yeah, Jurassic Park. Anyway. I hate you. So that's what you notice, Jared. And then, just like Kelb, you notice those two walk in and go up to Clara.
Speaking of which, I wanted to say to Lamb, you know, don't beat yourself up. A lot of places don't capture Dwarven. I mean, Elven architecture very well. You've been to several towns.
True. True. But this is the only first, this is the first city in a long time that's actually had a small place set for the elves.
Well, it's not so much as
they would be a bit closer to there.
It's not that there's a set place for them. It's that's where they actively decided to group up. So it's not like there's necessarily segregation in the city, even though there kind of is. It's not by choice. Or it's not by force.
It's, not
it's by choice.
Segregation. Yeah.
Right. They were like, we're all going to live over here with each other. And there's others spread about the city. But the vast majority of them are like, no, I want to live around my kind. So,
bunch of races.
That's all it is.
Yeah.
Kinda. I mean, it's the time period.
It's realm
to an
ride.
Extent.
Wait.
Anyway, so Calber, Jared, do either of you do anything prior to these two talking to Clara?
I look over to the door as they enter, but I remain seated.
Okay.
I'm sorry, did you say I finished my drink when they got up and left, by the way, Marcus? Or you just said they finished theirs?
They finished theirs. You could have if you wanted, but they finished theirs.
I did not, and just sit there and continue drinking.
Okay. Then we'll swap back over. Lamb, Tate, you guys walk up to Clara. What do you say?
I figured I would give someone else.
She greets you. Ah, hello.
Hi, lady. Room for two, please.
All right. Well, looks like two of your guildmates already have this room, so I'll give you a room next door. She hands you two keys, which are to room, again, for simplicity, two.
All right.
Do you both head off, or?
Yeah, I will thank her and head off to the room and sleep.
And you, Tate?
Would love to stay and chat, Clara, but I've got a big day tomorrow. Crowd to woo, you know.
Well, best of luck to you.
I do hope I do well.
Who stacked my fucking dice?
By the way, Marcus.
Yes.
Mason is asking if there is slavery in this world.
There's
I'm going to assume there is.
A what?
Slavery.
Yes and no. Not in this area.
In the world is what his question was worded as.
I mean, technically, everything can theoretically be in this world. It's just a matter of whether or not it pertains to the area and the story. I guess to answer Mason's question. It hasn't come up yet, let me put it that way.
So it will.
It might.
No, I'm just being a dick. Don't mind me.
Okay. Anyway. So you guys head on up to your room. What you two see, and it's the same thing for the other two that went to a room, which we have to get to in a second anyway, as well.
God, so many dice.
These rooms are... not like ours. There is a window, and you can think of any game that kind of takes place almost medievally-esque. But when you want to think about it, like the room's bathrooms, as an example, is a bucket with water on a pedestal as the sink, and a bucket to poop and pee in. It's not that you have toilets.
Just don't mix those up.
Yeah, just don't mix them up. The beds are nicer beds. They're not just pieces of, you know, cloth thrown on some wood. It's actually wood with cloth and hay and wool and whatnot, along with bed sheets. But
still. That room chores.
This, by the way, did not turn out any way like I thought it would.
That is definitely not the rooms. Holy crap. Nevertheless, so.
The flat image looks a lot better, by the way.
That's what the rooms you guys go into. So it's nice. For this time period, this is nice. You know, just not like, oh, I go to the sink and I turn on the water and what fucking time period do you think this is?
Internet.
So, Rome? Yeah, it's future.
I go online and search up the resources to fight a green dragon.
So,
cash for credit.
Who was in what room?
Me and Lambert, room two.
That's right. Demois went to the room Noah was already in. So, Noah. Demois.
Yes.
Noah, you enter your room, and after you've more than likely gotten ready for bed, and you did notice there was two beds in there, you hear a key, or just the handle if you didn't lock the door, opening the door, and enter Des Moines.
I see you'll be taking the other bed.
What was that?
I see you'll be taking the other bed.
That's to you, Des Moines.
I'm kind of lost in my book at the moment, and I just go lay down on the bed.
I'm going to head over to my bed while slowly mumbling, why do I always get the weird ones?
The thing I said last session.
All right, so...
Well, Lime, you're pretty much used to it.
At this point, then, Noah, does your character just kind of go to sleep, and then Des Moines, your character just kind of reads for a bit and then eventually also goes to sleep, or is there anything...
Indeed. Okay. I would imagine Des Moines' character...
Nothing amazing you guys necessarily want to do.